Good morning, everyone. It's 6:30, D-Day. At least I hope so. I woke up at 3. I had a good night's sleep, but 3 o'clock it was done. And I've been packing up things ever since. Isn't it amazing that there's still packing to be done? You know, Michael came over. We took the TV down yesterday off the wall. But we didn't take off the bracket. And I fought with that for half an hour. I didn't even think to ask him. He didn't think about it because he was busy looking at things to see if there was anything I was leaving behind. Funny is he went out to the shed because I had told the young kid buying the house that I'd be leaving some tools behind. We don't need them. We don't need them. Michael insisted we do. He's not wrong. But I just feel so horrible now because I'm not leaving anything behind. And it was funny because he walked out of the shed and starts walking around behind it. And I said, "What do you do?" And he goes, "Looking to make sure you're not hiding anything on me." No trust. No trust at all. So anyway, I have been sitting here and thought, you know what, just get going. I'm going to take a load out to the house, to the new house. And let me show you what I've got still. Okay, took the mattress down, took everything out of here, have this stuff that's gotta be taken. I think it will go now. Emptied the drawers underneath it. So that's all ready. This is all ready except for those pillows. Everything else is ready to go. The cat carriers are out. I've gotta take the TV, and I can take that out myself, but I think I will wait and not take it this trip. And then this is, look at this. And it's all stuff that I need, you know, I needed until today. Bedding, and I did a load of laundry again. Last minute stuff here. And thank you so much to all the people who reminded me that I wanted to take the cactus plant. While Michael was here, I went into the shed and got this pot and transplanted it. It'll be in shock for a while, but I think it'll be okay. So just made myself a cup of coffee and I'll be able to turn off the Keurig. Everything else, I'll just start packing up. The only other thing I have to remember is there's a bird feeder outside. It's, a bird bath. And it's nothing special. I don't even think it holds water, although I've repaired it half a dozen times, but it was my mother's. And Michael always loved it as a kid, so she wanted to make sure he got it, and that I have to make sure goes. The ladder behind the shed, I think I've got it. Karen came over last night, my older sister, and I'm sorry, Karen, that I said older. It's been a thing I've done all my life because people think that I'm older than her, so I always say older sister. I'm sure you all have something like that too. But she brought me some minestrone soup. Oh, it was so good. It was just so good. So she offered to come over today. I'm going to let her. I don't know that I'm going to need her to do anything, but she might be my moral support. I'm excited. It can't happen soon enough for me. So that's my update. I'm going to carry everything out. It's cold outside. I started the car and I'll finish making my coffee. And I'm going to start packing up the car as much as I can. I'll talk to you in a little bit. Guys, I'm videoing, so don't say anything bad. Or if you do say it bad, say it loud so they can hear it. The movers are here. They got here much earlier than I anticipated. So the cats are not in the bathroom. I can't find them. How can I not find them? All the furniture is pulled out. I don't understand it. Is that a cat? Oh, that looks like a cat in that corner. So this is all stuff that I have to take at the end. But we're early enough today that I should get back, be able to get the cats, if I don't lose them now, and clean this place up. I think I spotted... There's Parker. Parker, what, you know, it makes no sense. It makes no sense. I don't think you're hiding from anybody. I've put myself on door duty because the door has to stay open. So I'm hoping that the cats don't get so scared that they run by me. I can't imagine that happening. Anything's possible. Do I look as happy as I am? Funniest thing, I cannot get these guys to crack a smile. They don't find me amusing. Hard to believe, isn't it? I got Parker in the bathroom. She let me grab her by the scruff of the neck. She was more or less paralyzed with fear. I cannot find Feisty, and the house is empty, and she didn't go out the door. So I'm assuming she climbed up inside one of the couch or the chair, and I'm hoping when we get to the new house, she's there. Because she definitely did not leave the house through the door. I have no words. That's a first.
I'm more than halfway done.
10 o'clock. Empty. Empty. They're working outside, getting the shed. Got a couple little things here. And I'm just vacuuming, getting ahead of the game. The feeling I have right now is just elation, pure happiness. House is done. They're gonna close up and we're gonna head up to U-Haul for the next stop. I think we're making pretty good time. It's 11:15. And here we are. Okay, they're back in business. I don't know what happened, but they're back in business. I'm being serenaded. Wow. Karen came back to the house with me because Feisty was missing. But she ended up finding a way into a closet, which I didn't even know was open. Parker is having a breakdown. It's hard for me to not be flying to get to the house to let her out of that carrier, but she is just miserable. The poor thing. She's so scared. That's awful. So, 99% of the stuff is at the ranch. I have to go back to School Street, Dighton, tomorrow and wash the floors. Everything's vacuumed. I have some clothes still in the closet, only a handful. So I'll do that. The house is about 50% okay. The couch is set up. I'd like to get the modem set up for internet. I'd like to get the bed made up. Because I'm tired. It's 2 o'clock. I cannot see myself doing a whole lot. We'll see. I think I'm going to be around the house as much as possible for the next couple of days. And I've got busy days this week, but these two are gonna need some attention. So I'll be back when we get to the house. Well, everything's vacuumed, everything's semi-clean, and when I turn this off, I'm going to walk out of this house for the very last time. I'm struggling, but not for the reasons I would have expected. You know, kids went off to college, kids moved out, got divorced, husband moved out, so the biggest milestones I've already happened in this house. And I was worried with how long I'm going to want to do the upkeep because it's a pain in the neck. So I'm thrilled, nostalgic to close that door for the last time. But I'm probably going to cry. Life happens so goddamn fast, doesn't it? I'll be back. Okay, I said goodbye to Debbie and Mike. And it's done. It's done. Okay, on the road. Going to the house. Not the new house. The house. The house where I live. And yes, it's emotional. And I ran in and out of Deb and Mike's in 2 seconds because that was not going to be pretty. A quick pit stop. I have about 20 minutes of my own here. I want to go through the car wash. Well, I don't want to go through the car wash, but New England in the winter, my blue car is now a crappy looking gray white from all the salt. So let's get this a little bit better and then I'll head home. I'm very lucky because I have so much to do. Nikki and the little one are going to come over for a short time today so that Nikki can see if she can get the modem working so that I can get back to work here. I slept very well last night. Not a lot, but very well. The cats, on the other hand, yeah, not so much. They were hissing at each other most of the night, running back and forth. It was so traumatic for them, especially for Parker. Feisty kind of rolls with the punches, even though she whines and cries and all that. But Feisty howled and screamed. You heard her in the car. She was paralyzed. And as far as getting her in the carrier, she actually was so scared she was frozen. She just cowered in the corner. It was so sad. And I could go over and get her by the scruff of the neck. She didn't even fight me. She didn't even fight going into the carrier. It was probably the best thing for her to be contained, even though she'll tell you differently. So back to the new house. Got a vacuum before the little one gets there. And then slowly start finding places for things, even knowing that it's only for, you know, 6 months, maybe a little more. And trying to talk myself out of unpacking everything because it makes no sense. You know, I knew where everything was when I packed it. No. I'm going to have to open every carton because, no, I did not label them. I know. Who's surprised? So I'll check in later. Well, welcome to the ranch. I'm going to give you a quick tour. It hasn't even been 24 hours and I am not killing myself. Oh, let me show you where I'm at. Now remember, I'm not changing anything and it's just to make it livable while mine's being built. And as I told you before, this is all being ripped out. So it's all temporary, which thank goodness, because there is no space to work. There's no storage. Oh Lord, but look at this. Talk about making myself feel at home. I have a soup cooking. Probably won't taste good, but I have a soup cooking. I've got a dish drain coming, hopefully today. Table set up. There's a bunch of crap on the table. This is where I have to store the food, and this is not going to work for me. It may not look horrible, but they're deep. I hate it. I hate it. And it's, you know, not in the kitchen. So on this wall, I'm getting a couple of pantries. I think they're 5 foot tall and only a foot deep, so they don't take up too much space. And Mike and Nikki will be able to use them in the basement or the garage. And then this is the living room, for good, bad, or otherwise. It looks fine. Not bad, huh? Still haven't hooked the TV up, but almost. Nikki did come by and get internet working. Oh, look at those. Michael gave me flowers for Valentine's Day because he got some for Nikki and his daughter. I think he thought he needed to include his mom, which I told him not to do again because I get more pleasure out of watching him give to them. But I did say, I think it's the first time in my life that I ever got flowers for Valentine's Day. Bathroom, put the rug down, put up curtains. It's fine. And this is a disaster. That's what this is. But it's a work in progress. I can sit and do my makeup if I find my makeup. Oh, look at that. The cats have been underneath. I have my bed. And this is all staying. I will go through this, but I'm not in a hurry at all, at all. What I don't find, I can do without. Hey, Miss Barker. Stuff floating in my tea. Hi. Hi. You letting everybody know that you're okay? Huh? You okay in the new house? Huh? They're okay. Yes. Feisty is not making much of an appearance, but she never did. This one is feeling her oats. She's learning her way around. She... Bugger! You got me! So I'm in. The relief is palatable. But I think more than anything, I am truly just about numb. And I'm in disbelief. You know, 6 months ago, I had so much responsibility, so much going on, so much stress with the salon and having the two family. And all of a sudden today, I had nothing. And nothing to truly get horribly worried about. Now, I'm sure I'll find a way to worry about it anyway. But it's done. I'm sitting in a new home. And I'm fine because it's only temporary. Otherwise, I would have a sledgehammer out and be starting to do things. And I told Nikki that today. It's a good thing that they have plans to do some demolishing because otherwise, I kind of would have to. It's going to be good. Thank you for coming along on the ride. Thank you to my sisters for their help. And to Debbie Rose, who I just sent another text to and said, oh my God, can you go across the street? I forgot to clean out the refrigerator. It has milk in it. And I think I left something in the freezer. And I cannot go back. I can't go through it again. And she just texted me back fine. But Debbie was a godsend to all of this. I think it helped a lot by sharing it all with you. Thank you so, so much. And we'll continue the journey together. I'm done.